Good evening, you're watching news that deserve your attention. I'm Navya Singh and I'll quickly take you through the headlines today. Let's begin. Amid all the distraction, the focus remains on the deadly coronavirus pandemic. Remember, India today surpassed the United States to become the second worst hit country by the deadly coronavirus pandemic. India added over 1 lakh COVID infections just in 24 hours. And this is the first time that the country added more than 1 lakh COVID infections in just a single day. Maharashtra continues to be the worst hit state by the deadly coronavirus pandemic, and it added over 57,000 COVID infections in just 24 hours. Remember, we are still in the middle of a pandemic, in the middle of a second wave of infections as pointed by the experts, and the only way to curb the spread of this deadly virus is to follow all the safety protocols. A recent report by a French journal has alleged that the Rafale fighter jet deal involved a payment of 1.1 million euros to an Indian middleman as a gift. Now, after these allegations have surfaced, the Congress has attacked the BJP at the centre and accused the party and the government of corruption and also demanded an independent inquiry into the matter. Remember, the Rafale deal has been one of the biggest defence deals for India and is also India's first major acquisition of fighter jets in over 2 decades. The Rafale deal has been a part of the controversy ever since it was finalized. The Congress and the opposition in the past as well has accused the BJP and Prime Minister Narendra Modi of corruption and accused PM Modi of acting as a middleman for Indian businessman Anil Ambani in the deal. Shifting focus to the West Bengal elections now, a Congress candidate from Baghmandi Assembly constituency has alleged in an official complaint to the Election Commission that the CCTV cameras in the EVM strong room, or the room where EVMs are stored, were switched off for a considerable amount of time. Now, this complaint was filed by the Congress candidate on Saturday, and despite the complaint, the disruption reoccurred on Sunday. Responding to the allegations, the Election Commission on Monday said that the disruption occurred due to a technical glitch. Now, let's talk about what's happening in the national capital. Devotees of Sai Baba have now lodged a police complaint against dislodging of his idol in South Delhi. Now, the idol was taken down by the members of the temple committee and replaced by a Ganesh idol. While the temple committee members claim that the idol was taken down because it was old, a video, however, that has gone viral on social media shows the workers taking down the idol while a man is seen directing them and telling them that Sai Baba was no god and that he died in 1918 and that he was a Muslim. That's all for today, and I'll be back with some more important news tomorrow. Thanks for watching.